Everyone, welcome to beautiful Cahuilla Creek Motocross Park in Anza, California. I'm Don Maeda, Swapmoto Live, and we're here today for our 2023 Special Edition Shootout. So behind me, you see the Gas MC450 Factory Edition, Honda CRF450R Works Edition, Husqvarna FC450 Rockstar Energy Edition, Kawasaki KX450 SR, and the KTM 450 SXF Factory Edition. That's a mouthful. Anyway, so KTM really started something in 2010 when they came out with their first Factory Edition. So far, four other manufacturers have followed suit with special bikes available a little bit later than the others. Each of them have their own charm, their own personality. Some of the bikes, like the Austrian bikes, are just the same standard ones this year, except they have clamps, exhaust pipes, and different graphics, while the Honda and Kawasaki tend to lean more towards the high performance side with engine packages. So we've spent some time on all five of the bikes, but we're gonna ride them head to head today for the first time. Making this all possible for us today are OGO Power Sports, manufacturers of the best gear bags in the world, and Motul Oils, who have supplied all the lubricants, engine oils, chain lubes, the shiny stuff, etc., etc. So thanks to those guys, and also thanks to Jake Clark at Dirt Bike TV for outfitting all the bikes with brand new MX33 Dunlop tires. I've got five test riders: Kyle Vara, Pat Foster, Kyle Perner, Connor Erickson, and myself, and we're gonna have a good time today out at Cahuilla Creek.
Hey everybody, Pat Foster with Swapmoto Live. Just finished up an amazing day here at Cahuilla Creek. We got our 2023 edition shootout. Man, it's so much fun to be able to get these bikes back to back. It's so telling when you jump off one right onto the other one. You can immediately feel the differences. And man, I came away today with a very clear winner, the Kawasaki SR, the Special Racer. Man, that's a great bike. So a couple of things that I really like about it. A lot of 450s these days are going towards a long, broad, smooth power delivery. These are fast bikes with a lot of power, and the average consumer wants a smooth power delivery. But for me, I'm riding for fun now. I don't race a whole lot. I want to have a good time on my bike. And for me, the quick hit and the grunt and the excitement out of the Kawasaki just makes it so much fun. This thing hits hard. It's loud. It's got a bunch of punch to it down low, which I think is really, really fun. Great mid-range, tons of top end. It doesn't have more top than some of the other bikes, but it's just got a lot of excitement down low and a lot of mid-range punch, and it's really, really fun. The other thing that I really like about this bike is the suspension. I sat on the bike in the pits and I'm just rocking it back and forth, and it feels so plush and free compared to some of the other bikes that have an air fork. Right, the air fork's got to be tighter. It's the nature of how it works. And I'm thinking to myself, this is too loose. This is going to be too soft for me. I'm definitely going to need to come back and add some compression. And the first jump I hit, I went a little bit long, and I was bracing for a big hit, and I was so surprised at how good the bottoming resistance was. So it's just a great balance of plushness up top, absorbing the small chop, but good confidence-inspiring bottoming resistance on the big jumps. I love the Kawasaki ergonomics. There's plenty of room to move around. There's plenty of adjustment in the bike. but it's narrow, it's sleek, it corners good. It's a great balance of straight line stability and good cornering, which is hard to get with an exciting motor package. And so for me, it's an easy first pick. Second, third, and fourth are the Austrian bikes for me. And you know, it's odd. I could go to three different people and recommend all three different bikes to somebody else, right? It just depends on what you're looking for. For me, I like the KTM. It's my second choice. You know, their moniker is Ready to Race, and I like that about that bike. I appreciate it. The engine is aggressive. The thing comes on hard, especially in Map 2. It's got a little bit of friendliness at the bottom. It's got some torque. It's a little bit smooth, which makes it somewhat easy to manage. And then the mid-range kicks in, and the thing pulls so hard, and it's sometimes overwhelming. But to me, that's fun, and I like that. The bike feels stiffer. It feels more rigid than some of the other bikes. It wants to be ridden hard. If you're not riding it hard, it's not as much fun because it's not built for plushness. It's not built for comfort. This thing's ready to go fast. And so when you're going fast, it rewards you. When you're cruising, it doesn't feel as good. So even though the chassis setup is similar amongst the three, there are differences in the airbox configuration, and that changes the power pretty significantly. And for me, the KTM has the most power. I like that. Some things I don't like that the handlebars are stiff. You feel a little bit more engine vibration. You feel a little bit more of the track in the KTM, but when you're riding hard, it's good. Next for me is the GasGas, and it's just a little bit milder. The airbox configuration on the GasGas offers a little bit smoother power delivery. It's a little bit muted. The GasGas had a little bit more time on it than the KTM, so it felt a little freer. The suspension was looser, a little more plush. The engine revved a little freer, but it was a little milder delivery. I think a lot of people like that. Man, I love the looks of the GasGas. It's my favorite looking bike. So sharp looking. Really good on the track today. was the most time I've spent on it, and it was really good. And then the third of the three Austrian bikes is the Husky, and it's even a milder delivery. This is the bike that I'd probably, even though it's down in the rankings for me, this is the bike that I would probably recommend most often. And I've got a lot of buddies that ride Huskies for this reason. It's easy to ride, smooth delivery. It's a lot more manageable. It's not as overwhelming as the other two. However, one of the major differences with the Husky and the other two is the exhaust pipe. This one comes with an FMF pipe, and man, the mid-range is so free revving and pipey, and I really liked it. I was impressed with that FMF exhaust. It just really changed the character of the bike. So for those reasons, I don't like the Husky as much. It's a little bit mellower. It's a little bit easier to ride. Like I said, most people probably like it the best. And then I've got the Honda at the back, and it's so hard for me to do that because the Honda looks amazing. The ergonomics are second to none. I mean, the thing is so comfortable. It's so sleek and narrow. It feels the lightest of any of the bikes on the track. It's so nimble. It corners better than anything. It feels light in the air. Really a fun bike to ride. The power's aggressive. It's just such a wide variation in power deliveries. You can adjust it to however you want, and traction controls and all of these things. The power's fun. The bike's just a little disconnected from the track, and just this little bit of movement, a little bit of twitchiness, it just hampers some of the confidence a little bit to really push hard into the corners and attack the way that the bike deserves to be ridden, because it will corner so well. But when it just feels a little disconnected and a little sketchy, it's like, man, I want to dive into this turn, but I'm just holding up a little bit. I can figure those little things out, just a little bit of setup where you don't quite feel so much of the track feedback to the rider. Honda would be amazing. However, that is the case. It is a little disconnected. You do feel more of the track. The chassis is rigid, and that's the only thing that holds it back, because it's really a fun bike to ride. I spent a lot of time on this Honda. I took it home for a while, and I had a ball on it. But in race conditions, it can be a little bit of a handful.
What's up, everyone? My name is Kyle, and today we were doing the 450 Factory Edition Shootout. I got to ride all the bikes, and everything that I rode today was pretty impressive. But I did have a couple that stuck out, and I think that they definitely have their benefits, and it's something that's usually typically not my choice, but I think you'll be surprised. And in first place is the Husqvarna. That bike to me, even in the stock form, it was a little bit harsh, a little slow. All of those changes that were made to the factory edition definitely made that bike stand out. As far as power goes, the mid to the top end of the power and the engine on the Husky is amazing. It does definitely lack a little bit on the low end, but when it comes to engine power, I'll give up a little bit of the low end because you can make up for it with roll speed in the corners. When you get into the top end of the engine and you're pinned and the bike doesn't want to go any faster, it's a lot harder to make up. The Husky overall, I'm extremely surprised with the air fork that KTM and the Austrian brands are running. It doesn't feel like an air fork. It's pretty conventional, and it's actually one of my favorite air forks that I've ever ridden. I think one thing that doesn't get enough credit is the work that the KTM and the Austrian group has done with the air fork. The air fork, to me, I've never really liked air forks. The characteristics, they just never really felt natural to me. The air fork that has come on all three of these bikes is amazing, and I think the tunability is great. For instance, today, I felt like most of those bikes, when I got on them in stock form, when you get on the brakes, it wants to dive. So what we added, we went from 10.9 bars of pressure to 11.1, and that just kind of held the front end up a little bit and just gave it a little bit more front end feel, and also it didn't get as low into the stroke when you were hitting bumps or on the brakes. So on all those bikes, I went to 11.1, and that definitely changed the game for me. But I think the fork doesn't get enough credit. It's an amazing fork, and I can see why, you know, those bikes score as high as they do. A close second was the GasGas. And the GasGas has a very similar feel to the Husky. The only thing that I didn't like about the GasGas is the top end speed. Now that might be totally because of the pipe difference on each bike. And I just felt that at the top end of the engine, the GasGas kind of fell flat. And like I said, it's hard to make up power if it's not there. In third place was the KTM. And the KTM to me is pretty interesting because the bikes all share the same frame and most of the same components. However, the KTM felt a little stiffer, a little more rigid, and a little bit more tied up than the other two. The power of the KTM from top to bottom is amazing, and it's definitely the strongest engine of the group, but I just felt like the stiffness and the rigidness of the chassis was enough to knock it down into third place. In fourth place, which was a surprise to me, is the Kawasaki. The Kawasaki for sure has its own feel, and the Showa suspension is really plush up top. I found that it fell off a little bit deeper into the stroke, and it gets a little bit harsher the more you kind of hammer the bike. Like, the harder you hit bumps and stuff, it feels a little bit harsher, and it almost gives off a dead feel in the suspension. The Kawi, traditionally in the past and even for this year's bike, it wants to be ridden on the rear end. Like, you want to be hanging off the back, steering the thing with the rear wheel. And I just feel like the Austrian bikes, it's complete opposite, where you're more centered, you have both wheels on the ground, you really get a good feel for traction. The Kawasaki is the complete opposite. The Kawi's engine is amazing, and the pipe, the PZ pipe, makes the thing rev to the moon. And I definitely love the power characteristics of that engine. The only thing I felt like it lacked was traction, overall traction. And that's why it placed where it placed. Last up is the Honda. Although the factory edition is much better than its stock brother, I just felt that there's some characteristics of the Honda, and I think it's in the chassis, that they're still lurking, they're still in there. The better suspension, and on the factory edition, it has a bigger diameter shock shaft. It definitely helps dampen some of the bumps, and you kind of get a little less twitchiness, and it's not as sketchy as the stock bike, but it's still in there, and it's just not very confident inspiring. So I just didn't feel confident on that bike. The power of the engine is amazing. I know they did some work to the head. They polished all the ports, and it's running a pipe, and a different mapping setup. And the power is amazing. It just, you got to be able to control that power, and I just felt like the Honda just falls a little bit short. It's still a great bike. I'm sure there's some great tracks and some beneficial areas of tracks that you could probably rip on the Honda, but overall, looking at it from a comparative test of all the bikes that we've tested today, I just felt that it fell a little short.
It's the end of a long day, another shootout, another day riding five different bikes. But for me, it's no real surprise that I like the KX450 SR Kawasaki the best. You know, I've purposely not been riding a Kawasaki all year because I knew this was coming up. And yeah, just got on the thing. Felt like putting on an old comfortable shoe that was trustworthy, comfortable, and plenty fast. The difference between this year's SR and last year's is the show of suspension. Personally, I think the KYB was a little bit more comfortable, a little bit more plush feel on initial parts of the travel. But other than that, man, the SR rips. The Kawasaki and the Honda take a different approach because they have their engines modified on the special edition bikes. And the KX450 SR is a monster. It has almost like a second hit up top where the standard KX signs off. And man, it makes the bike super fun to ride. Great front to rear suspension balance. Feels long, stable, trustworthy. I did things that got me into trouble on the other bikes on the Cali and was just fine. So for me, clear cut winner, KX450 SR. After the Cali, I was surprised, man. I really like the Gas MC450 Factory Edition. It's hard for me to believe, like I was grilling the KTM group guys about the differences between the KTM, Gas, and Husky, and they say all it is plastic, the subframe, and the Husky has FMF pipe. The other two bikes have Akrapovic. No mapping differences between the three. Very, very, very hard for me to believe. The Gas is easy to ride. It's not as powerful and monstrous as the KTM, but it's got a light, free revving feel, makes the bike feel real light. The suspension was super plush and comfortable. Of the three bikes, the suspension's the most comfortable yet racy on the Gas. So the new red bike is pretty awesome, man. I really like that thing and I could see myself racing that all year. Next was the KTM for me. Compared to the Gas, like I thought I was gonna feel pretty much the same with the orange front fender, but it has a slower revving, higher friction feel on the engine. I guess that could be due to the airbox differences. Yeah, the KTM was good. Very powerful, very racy. I think it's too much bike for me, to be honest, but yeah, I like that thing third. Fourth for me is the Honda CR450R Works Edition. Man, that thing is really, really fast. If you try to ride it all aggro on the pipe, it gets me in a lot of trouble. But if you shift up a gear and lug it a little bit, it tames down the whole bike, calms down the chassis, and I was getting along with the bike really well today. Yeah, I feel like the suspension could be a little more plush. I actually went out on clickers quite a bit today on the Honda. I think I'd narrow it down to a stiff chassis feel. But as with anything, if I rode the Honda full time, I could get used to it and have a great time. The Husky brings up the rear for me. Again, talking about the differences that the KTM group say the bikes have, it shouldn't be that big of a difference. But the Husky to me feels harsh, it feels heavy, and it's just not as pleasurable to ride. I was the least comfortable on the Husqvarna FC450 Rockstar Edition. And yeah. All five of these bikes, those are pretty badass, and it's amazing that the manufacturers produce something like this as an option for those who can afford to buy something really nice.
Hey, what's up guys? It's Butter here at the 2023 Edition Shootout for Swapmoto Live out here at Cahuilla, having a fun time riding with our buddies, getting to ride all these dirt bikes, and it was a great day riding these things, and I really enjoyed it, and I can tell you what, these things are fast. So I'm gonna put Kawasaki as number one. I just really gelled with that bike. I feel like anyone can get on that bike and adapt very easily. It's such an easy bike to ride, and it's very predictable too with the chassis and the characteristics. You kind of just know what the bike's going to do. It stays planted very well. The suspension was, I'd say, by far the best out of all the bikes. It has such good hold up, especially on the fork. It's plush when you need it too, though, but it's got great hold up. So when you hit some bigger jumps or some of these bumps, you can count on it always being there. And that thing is fast. Let me tell you what, as soon as you get on the gas, that thing rips like a rocket ship. It's pretty broad too and pulls all the way through. Loud, barks. The Cowie barks so hard. But yeah, I really enjoyed riding that bike. So I'd say Kawasaki's number one for me. Number two would be Honda. There's kind of has characteristics like a Cowie. It's a little bit more twitchy, but they did some changes this year and the bike actually is really good. And it's at home for me. I've always been on Honda, so I enjoyed riding that bike. And then third, KTM. That thing's a good bike, all around solid. It's kind of a sleeper. It's like quiet and you think it's gonna roll on slow, and then when it hits, it guns it. It goes so fast, all around solid bike. The Husky, that was fourth for me. I really enjoyed riding that thing. It was the last bike of the day. I was a little tired and it did exactly what I wanted it to do. It was a great bike overall. Love riding that thing. Even with the air fork, some people don't like that, but I thought it was overall a great bike. And then Gas was last for me. Not saying it's a bad bike by any means, but of the three, that's how I would rank it. Obviously, any bike you ride, you're gonna have fun on it. It's all personal preference on what color you want, but that's how I'd rank it today, and had a good time riding these things.
All right, so another 450 shootout in the books, factory editions. Or my favorite bike for this year was really close between the Kawasaki and the KTM, but I chose the Kawasaki. It just seems to have just a great package, fantastic motor, great balance to the bike, has really good plush suspension with great hold up, and I just feel so safe on this bike. It just is super stable, but yet nimble and turns really well. So for me, the Kawasaki was just the best bike I could possibly ask for. KTM was a really close second. Completely different bike than the Kawasaki in a bunch of different ways, but it has a real racy feel. Just the bike likes to drive forward real well and connects to the ground. I love the way the KTM turns, especially like in flat corners. It just seems to, the front end bite is really, really good. I think the only thing that holds it back from being the winner is that the motor has a bit of a vibration to it. And after riding some of the other bikes that don't vibrate, you get on the KTM and it does have that vibration, and then it does start to bother me a little bit. But for the most part, it's just an amazing bike. So suspension overall was really good. Not quite as plush as the Kawasaki, but has real good performance, so good hold up, and seems to just turn and react really well and real responsive on the track. Third place for me was the Honda. I really like the Honda. It has really good balance, really good feel. The motor is absolutely insane, although I feel like on the Honda, I ride in higher RPM or lower RPM, so I short shift it and, you know, lug it around in third, and it seems to keep the chassis calm, and the bike seems to have really good balance that way. I struggled a little bit, like when I put it in the faster maps, and it seems like if I slow the bike down, keep the balance good, I really start having a good time on that Honda. I like the way the rider triangle is on the Honda, just like from the time you sit on it, when you're out there on the track, it just has a really good feel between your hands, your knees, your legs, and your feet. So, anyways, yeah, Honda, great bike. Gas, I guess, is next. Another great bike. It feels like it's a little bit of a tamed down version of the KTM, if that makes sense. It's not quite as fast, but it still has that bit of a racy feel, but with a little more comfort, like a little more comfort, a little less performance, I guess, with the Gas. But I kind of liked it, because when the track gets super rough and is really hard to ride, that bike does just exceptionally well. The Husqvarna, good bike, but I think I struggled with it today trying to find a good setting. It's definitely different feeling than the KTM and the Gas. I tried a bunch of different things and I did get it better, but I think I'd really need more time to spend on that bike. I just felt a little off, not quite as balanced. The bike felt a little skatey underneath me and it had kind of a harsh and stiff feeling. And the motor seems to rev a little slower. So it gives it kind of a little bit of a heavier feel. But all these bikes are great out here. You can't go wrong with any of them. With some testing and some work, you can get them all just great.
For the second year in a row, the Kawasaki KX450 Special Racer earned an easy win. Unchanged from last year, save for Showa suspension components instead of KYB, the green machine was liked best by all but one of our test riders. Truth be told, last year's KX450R was superior in every test rider's memories, as the KYB suspension yielded a more plush, comfortable ride. Still, the excellent handling character and monstrous power output of the SR power plant made it the clear-cut favorite in the bunch. The KTM 450 SXF again came home a solid second, leading its two Austrian brothers in the final standings thanks to its ready-to-race performance. True to the brand slogan, the KTM is the most aggressively set up of the three Pura Group machines, with a hard-hitting power band and firm suspension components. The GasGas MC450F Factory Edition is the new player in the Special Edition category, as the newest GasGas is built on the same platform as the KTM and Husqvarna bikes. Closer in feel and performance to the KTM than it is to the Husky, the GasGas is slightly tamer, power-wise, than the KTM, but racier than the Husqvarna. While the KTM and Husqvarnas have an aluminum and composite hybrid subframe, the GasGas rear end is 100% aluminum. The Husqvarna finishes fourth. While most testers didn't get along with its slower revving power band and the heavier feel that is a result of the power delivery, one of our testers liked the bike best, thanks to its high revving top end pull. The Honda CR450R Works Edition fared better amongst test riders in 2023 and actually tied the Husky in points, but the tiebreaker was given to the Husky as it was chosen first by one of our test riders. The CRF is brutally fast and rewards an aggressive rider who can ride at race pace all of the time. Unfortunately, the red bike's quick handling and aggressive nature can catch a rider off guard if he loses concentration for even a split second. Diehard Honda riders, however, will love the Works Edition, but when ridden back to back with the other Special Edition offerings, it just didn't inspire as much confidence.